So you've got your product, let's target some customers. What's going on everybody, it's your boy, the Beast of Ecom, and I'm back with another video dropping nothing but, you already know, value bombs. If this is the first time ever watching one of my videos, then where have you been? I drop nothing but weekly value to help you guys make more money with e-commerce, Shopify, and dropshipping. So please, please do, if you get some value, like, comment, and of course, smash that subscribe button. Make sure you hit the notification bell as well, because you do not want to miss out on any of my upcoming content. So in today's video, I want to talk about targeting and how you can target customers. What's the best way to target? You've got your product, and now it's time to jump into the ads manager and actually target some customers. Now, there's many different ways you can target, and it generally comes down to the amount of budget you've got to play with. But what I wanted to do in this video is show you guys just how I would set up an advert as if I was to test a product out. Now, I've already got the product. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna actually show you the product and then actually show you the targeting as well in the ads manager. So by the end of this video, you're gonna be able to see the sorts of ad sets targeting that I would use for this specific product, okay, and what I would put live for a test. Remember, testing is literally that. You're casting your net out to find out which audiences are biting and reacting to that specific product and ad creatives. So make sure you watch all of the video, stay to the end. You know that I drop nothing but value bombs, but most importantly, implement and go out there and test. So let's quit the talking, let's jump into the computer and let's get on with it. Okay, so let's jump straight into this video. No BS, just pure actionable content. Okay, so let's crack on with it. Now, how to target with Shopify Facebook ads. This is the product that we're going to be selling, okay, or targeting specific audiences for. As you can see, it's a baby water float device. It is one that I showed in one of my other videos, actually, of a hot product to sell in summertime. It is a fantastic product. I think it comes with a video as well. But the first thing is first, okay? You need to have an avatar in mind. Now, I'm not talking about an avatar, one of those weird, crazy blue things in the movies. I'm talking about an avatar of the person who you're going to be selling to. So, of course, this here, naturally, we're showing it to parents. Now, women, mothers, grandparents who are purchasing it for their son or daughter's newborn baby. So that's the avatar that you need to have in mind. Age ranges, we're going to be looking at around about the 25 to 65, because we're going to be including, you know, grandparents right up to people to 25, you know, years old to, you know, I'm not sure when you have babies nowadays, but they're the sort of ranges that we're going to be using with, okay? So moving on now. Now, I'm not going to go into campaign creating. I'm not going to go into ad creatives and stuff like that. That's a completely different video. I just want to talk about targeting, okay, for this product. So for anyone who is wondering, this campaign itself is a website conversion campaign. Of course, we've got the purchase here. Now, obviously, this one's red because I don't advertise on this whatsoever. Yours may be green if you've got purchases. If you haven't and it's still red, I tend to go with purchase if it's a new account, if it's a new pixel, only because I want Facebook to send me buyers and people who have buying intent. Okay, so scrolling down here, we've got our budget. Again, it all depends on testing, all comes down to the amount of budget that you've got to play with. The more that you've got to play with, the more you can test. But let's just put this at 8 as a happy medium between 5 and 10. Moving on, worldwide. Now, some people do target worldwide and it can be fantastic, but you may, to start out with, you may be sending stuff to weird and wonderful places and not have any tracking numbers whatsoever. Or alternatively, it's gonna take absolutely ages. We're talking about 60 days, 2 to 3 months to get their product, which is very bad, okay? So generally, to start with, you just wanna start with e-packet countries, okay? Now, I've already created a list for this. So if you hit browse, untick that, save locations. I've got one called e-packet beast. And if I select that, it's all the countries that people can, that they can send via e-packet. So I'm going to get tracking number from A to B. Okay, so if PayPal do say anything, I've got those tracking numbers. And it's going to be a lot quicker. So moving on from that, if you don't know what these are, by the way, you can just literally just do a Google search. It will pull them up. I have got rid of some of the different countries on there, such as Vietnam and Japan and Russia and those sorts of countries, which I don't want to be advertising in. So remember, as I mentioned before, we're going to get about 25 to 65. We're going to be going to women. Okay. Now, here's our targeting. You just want to put in a broad keyword. Now, you can use audience insights, but this suggestion tool is fantastic for finding audiences. So we're looking at babies, okay? So the first thing that comes to my mind is babies is pregnancy. As you can see, we've got 68 million here. And moving on from that, we want to edit our placements. Now, again, people always ask, what's the ideal size? I generally like to go for big audiences, big, broad audiences, only because it gives a load of room to scale. And also what I like to do is I always generally tend to have one interest per ad set. But again, it comes down to the amount of money that you've got to test. If you haven't got that much to test, again, I wouldn't group loads of different broad ones in here, because this will just turn into 120 million. And, you know, it's just pointless. And of course, if you've got big broad ones, big broad interests per ad set, of course, it can lower your CPMs because you've got a bigger audience to play with. So that's what I generally like to do, but we'll go through and try and show you a little bit of a mix. So pregnancy as one, scrolling down, edit placements. Now this will be on automatic, of course. Take off audience networks, don't need that. Don't need messenger. Take off marketplace, take off right column, take off Instagram articles. Now, again, I like to have just Facebook feeds. Okay. I like to separate out Instagram into a new campaign rather than have it in here. But again, it comes down to the budget that you've got. If your budget isn't high, you can of course just have, the Instagram feeds and, Instagram feed and Facebook feed and see which ones are giving you the best ROAS. But what I generally do like to do is I like to take off Instagram and just have Facebook. And if it works on Facebook, then move it over to Instagram. That's just personal preference for myself. So we're working with 49 million here. So as you can see, pregnancy, we've got pregnancy as one. We're targeting e-packet countries. So yeah, that's looking all well and good. We're searching for conversions. I generally have it on 7-day clicking and 1-day clicking after view. That's what generally works for myself. Feel free to test, but 7-day clicking always generally seems to work for myself and what I've always pretty much used. Obviously lowest cost, and yeah, so that is one sort of audience that we can use. Okay, very broad. We've got our $8, we're on purchase, and for this one, of course, we can just put so women brackets, and what is it we're targeting on here? We're doing pregnancy, and it's 25 to 65. And we're mobile and desktop. Okay, you can obviously put in your countries as well if you wanted to call it e-packet, so that you know that it's your e-packet countries, and then when you scale worldwide, you can obviously change this to worldwide. So that's what we're working with one audience. Okay, now obviously in this ad set here, I've got my two creatives. I always like to have two creatives and give Facebook a lot more to work with, okay, and generally find out which one is doing the best. Again, I'm not going to go into them, and it would just be a case of duplicating this. So let's load the duplication, and then what we want to be looking at is different sort of angles. Okay, what are the sort of different angles we can work with this? So first and foremost, we want to take that off. Now, if we scroll down, keep the budget exactly the same, keep our countries the same, and hit the suggestions tool, it's going to give us loads of different audiences, okay, that we can use. Now, one of the great ones here is this sort of demographic here. New parents, as I mentioned, fantastic audience here who we're working with. It's got 2.3 million people, a fantastic size there. This is going to be showing people, this is going to be showing the advert to parents who have just got a newborn, essentially. Now, you want to be careful because, of course, if you scroll down and have a look at some of these, if you see new parents here, it's got something called source. And if you look at that source, it'll say it's a partner category based on blah-de-blah-de-blah. But basically, your CPMs are going to rise if you use this one here. Why? Because obviously it says here, no more than 15% of your spend will be used to cover your data costs. So try to avoid these sorts of demographics. If it says source on there, this one's okay. We can use this. So again, this would be another great audience, new parents. So we'll take new parents and just put that as that there. Let's delete that there. Let's duplicate again. Try and find a different angle. You've got to be thinking outside the box. So, you know, what sort of, this tool here at the bottom here is fantastic for doing suggestions. I'm coming up with different angles that you can use. So we go suggestions, infants is not really, that's probably small, childcare, breastfeeding is another fantastic one, which means they've obviously got a baby if they're interested in breastfeeding. 12 million people, fantastic. And again, the sizes, I generally like to target no less than a million if possible. If the audience size is less than a million, then what I like to do is I will just stack it with something else so that it is over a million. So breastfeeding, I'm not sure why my nose is so itchy, but let's carry on with this. Breastfeeding, scroll down. Parenting, birth is another fantastic one. So here's another angle as well, is brands, okay? So if we're looking at brands, we can take off breastfeeding, and Pampers is a diaper company or a nappy company if you're here in the UK. Huggies. So if we scroll down, we go Huggies. 3.3. So I generally leave this as that, okay, only because it's got 3.3 million people. And, you know, that's fine by me. But if your budget is a little bit less, you know, you don't want to split them out, then you can group them together. Of course, they're all brands. 6 mils, okay. Johnson's Baby, how much is this going to push up by? 7 mil. So, yeah, we could just call this one here. Again, it comes down to your budget. Remember, testing all comes down to your budget. But if your budget isn't, you don't want to split them out as much, you can see that these are all the same sort of things. They're all brands that mothers, okay, would purchase. So Huggies, Johnson's, Pampers, which are all diaper companies, and we can just put diaper companies, and let's duplicate one more. God damn, my nose, what is going on? Let's do one more. So let's take these off. What suggestions have we got here? Baby shop, new parents, baby sling, baby bottle. Let's so childcare, baby bottle, baby shower is a fantastic one. So people who are interested in baby shower, where their newborn baby has just been born, 7.5 million people. Now, as I mentioned before, you can do flex targeting on some of them as well, as I mentioned, which is fantastic to actually narrow down. So what you could do on this one is, if you want people with buying intent, you can do shopping online. Brings it down a little bit more, so there's not really a reason why you could add that one. You could leave it as that, so we know that we've got people who are baby shower flex. Okay, we know it's a baby shower flex. So as you can see how we're building these up now, let's just do one more, duplicate. So wait for my computer to load. Take off the copy. And let's see what else we can rock with. Now this product as well was, I believe it's, you can use it for babies that are 1 to 2 as well, who are not old. And what sort of numbers are we rocking with there? 2.5 million, okay, parents. Okay, so let's add up there as well. So as you can see there, we've now got six ad sets, okay? Six different ad sets, six different sort of angles that we're working with. Parents, diaper different companies, breastfeeding, pregnancy, baby shower, flex. So we've got a range of different audiences that we can work with here now, all of which have got different creatives as well. So not all different creatives, sorry, but of all, each ad set has two creatives. So we've given Facebook a lot of different information here to work with, and we can just run this and see how this would work and how this would operate over the next 24 to 48 hours. Because the audiences are so big as well, we can break it down. We might find that 35 to 44 may be a fantastic age and converting. We can then break that in and go down a little bit deeper. But hope this has really helped yourself out into terms of targeting. As usual, I hope you got some value from this video. If you did, please, please, please like, comment, and of course, smash that subscribe button. Hit the notification bell as well so you stay up to date with all of my latest content. Remember, ultimately, it is about testing, okay? And the more targeting and the more audiences that you can find, then the better results that you are going to have. Remember, the person who tests the most generally wins the most. Again, it all comes down to the amount of budget that you've got to play with. If you did enjoy this style of content, then please do just give it a like, and of course drop a comment down below. I do read a lot of the comments. It helps me out, and most importantly helps you out as well with the videos that I put out. Okay, I've got a free mastermind course and free course as well. Links will be all down below. And hit me up on Instagram, drop me a like, drop me a follow, drop me a DM, and we can try and connect on there. So as I've mentioned, that is it for this video. I'll be back with another one. As you already know, dropping nothing but value bombs. So take care, and I'll see you later.